It calls for New Zealand to take up a new technology that monitors fishing quotas from the sea to the plate. The World Wildlife Fund says the new device has had a successful trial in Fiji and will help make our fisheries more sustainable. Emily Cooper has more.
From the sea, to the boat, to the processing plant, the supermarket, and onto your plate. New technology that one day soon could tell consumers where the fish came from.
With this technology, you will know. So you will rest assured eating fabulous fish, knowing it's been legally fished, it has been caught sustainably, and it has not used slave labour.
It's called the Blockchain Project, and it uses a radio frequency device to track fish from catch to the supermarket with GPS precision. Tuna catch records are currently on paper, entered into databases. The project's been piloted in Fiji with tuna, and WWF has hailed it as a success.
New Zealand is a superb test case for this type of rollout of technology on a national scale.
Randall Bess says this technology will allow more transparency in the fishing industry, and it could be rolled out for all types of fishing.
Well, I'd really encourage the government to look earnestly at this technology, and I do know that some people are already looking at it.
MPI says it's working with providers to explore new technologies, including blockchain, to increase the transparency and traceability of products and to ensure the sustainability of fish stocks.
The next step for WWF is to get a retailer on board. It's too soon to say what the cost would be, but the organisation is confident.
It's a reality probably in the next 5 years, where you'll be able to use your smartphone and scan a QR code and almost basically have an augmented reality story to tell you which boat, which fisherman, where did that fish come from, and how did that voyage all the way to the can of tuna or the fresh tuna that you see in front of you.
New technologies to be explored as New Zealand consumers become more conscious about the story behind the food they eat. Emily Cooper, One News.